My mother survived the Holocaust, World War II. God has me serving him in the Holocaust of abortion here in America today.
Sol Pitchon has a heritage of survival. That heritage began in Nazi Germany as Hitler's directive of the final solution was being carried out to eliminate the so-called Jewish problem, extermination.
My name is Armin Pitchot. I'm a Holocaust survivor.
In 1942, when she was a teenager, Sol's mother, Jarmaine, and her Jewish family were forcibly rounded up and put on a train headed for Auschwitz. After traveling without food and water for 8 days, the crowded boxcar arrived at the infamous concentration camp.
She got off the train. The Nazis took her mother and 5 sisters in that direction and to the gas chambers that day, and she went to Block 10, which was an experimental block.
I was scared.
There was about 300 young girls, young ladies, and what they did is they sterilized them, gave them shock treatments. So there was my mother, right around 16 years old, finding herself on the operating table. And here the Nazi doctor, Dr. Mengele, he personally operated on her, removed one of her ovaries, ready to remove the other one.
Saul says what happened next was a miracle.
The Allied forces started bombing. And so the Nazi doctor, along with the soldiers, ran for cover. And that doctor instructed the imprisoned Jewish doctor to finish her up, to remove the other ovary. And so he told her, he says, young lady, I've got to make an incision, but I'm not going to remove that organ. And yet I want you to do 2 things. One, I want you to hide your cycle each month. And secondly, remember me when you have children.
If his boy gave my son Solomon somewhere, it's a promise.
Jarmaine kept her promise and did. Years later, Saul became her firstborn. He believes his mother's life was spared, so one day he could help spare the lives of others.
They were an unwanted people. Those unwanted people today are the unborn. Because of what my mother went through, she fought to live. That baby is fighting to live. If we don't take a stand and intervene as Christians, who will?
He's now a guardian for the unborn. As president and CEO of New Life Solutions, Saul and his staff provide support for women to carry their unplanned pregnancies to birth.
We got to continue to be the voice for those who don't have a voice here in the Tampa Bay area. 1 out of every 3 babies is being aborted. You know, the ultimate injustice is to be deprived of life.
The Pregnancy Center of Pinellas County provides free pregnancy tests, sonograms, ultrasounds, and a birth center, the first of its kind nationally, staffed by certified nurse midwives. They also initiate ministry in the moment of crisis.
They come in fearful, and they needed a ministry, an organization like ours, that they could come to and see that they could have a support system that's right here to help them choose what's healthy, what's right, what is godly.
Jennifer and Phil Petrini needed reassurance about their pregnancy. They met with the staff to make a thoughtful and informed decision about the life of their son.
We really came in because we were panicking that I was pregnant, but it ended up being so that we could save his life. Just realizing that this was a life and a child and not just a mistake.
They're able to answer all the medical questions and provide that sonogram for that young lady. When they see their baby, 90% of the time, they bond with their baby, and there they start the process of choosing life.
Both women and men benefit from post-abortion grieving.
We're telling them they can be forgiven and set free. They can move on with their lives. We're one of the few centers in the country reaching out to the men, helping them deal with their past abortion because they've not receive that forgiveness that God has for them.
The center documents more than 2,000 babies birthed through their services. Estimates suggest many more at other locations that became more convenient for clients who often come back to say,
you were there for me. You were there for my baby. You're the ones who took a stand on my side when my boyfriend wanted to abort. You're the one, and I cannot thank you enough.
Sol Pitchon, born from a Holocaust survivor, born to defend life.
We are praying for God to send in people who are hurting, those who are needing help, needing their lives changed and transformed. Let's change this culture of death back to a culture of life, the way God meant it to be.